that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself. He that believeth not God hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. And this is the record, that God hath given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. The Bible says you can know that you have eternal life. In the verse, it explicitly states that if you believe on the name of the Son of God, you can know that you have eternal life. I talk to many people that say they're saved. I talk to many people that say they have eternal life. I talk to many people that say that they're born again, but they don't know how to get eternal life or explain how to get it. Most people will just tell you to be a good person. Most people will tell you to give money to poor people. Some people will tell you just pray to God all the time, or just read your Bible daily, or go to church, or get water baptized, or speak in tongues. None of those things can save you. No righteous deed can save your soul. And the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 4:3-4, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. My friend, it's time to fear God. It is time to fear God. The Bible says in Matthew 10:28, fear not them which kill the body and are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. In Hebrews 10:31, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. But the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. My friend, fear God and flee from the wrath to come. Because the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians 5:9, for God hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ. You can have the testimony of Hebrews 12:2, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself. God's righteous, holy, sinless blood was not shed for nothing. The Bible says in Leviticus 17:11, for the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon an altar to make an atonement for your souls, for it is the blood that maketh an atonement for the soul. The Bible says in Hebrews 9:22, and almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission. The Bible says in Colossians 2:14, concerning Jesus Christ, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross. The Bible says in Revelation 1:5, Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, and the first begotten of the dead, and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. In Colossians 1:20, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him reconciling all things unto himself, by him I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven. Colossians 2:14, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. 1 Peter 1:18, for as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. In Philippians 2:5-10, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God hath highly exalted him, and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven, and things on earth, and things under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.